setting up your business manager account. So if you're getting started with Facebook, or you've been with Facebook and you've run ads with them for a while, make sure your business manager account is set up. There's multiple reasons. You have more features when you have your business manager set, business manager account set up properly. You can also do catalogs, integrate things, get more partners, all that stuff. So business manager account, if you're new to Facebook and you're wanting to start ads, first go here and set up your business manager account. It's super important. It's super simple. It takes a few minutes just to get it set up. We can walk you through that process. So when you first get started, you're gonna just come into the business. You just type in business.facebook.com and that pulls up the business manager account. Obviously, if you already have a business manager account, it's gonna log you into that account already. So if you're new, we'll walk you through that step. So you're gonna hit create account. You obviously have to be logged in to your Facebook account to get started. I've already got multiple business accounts, so we're gonna take you through a different way. So you click create account. So it's gonna have this pop up. And so it's gonna just start off by having you fill out your names. So first you wanna put in the business name of your account. So first you're gonna wanna put in the business details in here, so your business and an account name. So just write that in. It can be whatever you want because nobody else will see it. Then you of course want to put your name in and your business email that's associated with that. Then just click the next button. And then you're gonna put in obviously your details, your business details, your country, your street address, your towns, all that stuff. Make sure you submit this information. I'm not gonna show you my information. Hopefully you don't share yours with other people. Then you wanna either click, are you promoting this, your own products and goods and services, or are you an agency and you're promoting other people's products and agencies? Once you click submit, then you're gonna be sent an email to confirm and so forth. Once you're in, you're gonna log into your business manager account. So it's gonna show up your business manager name up at the top right and also here in this. So coming into the next steps, what you're gonna do is you're gonna have pages, add an account, and you can add people. So walking through that, so obviously you can connect it to one of your existing pages you already have set up, or you can set up a new page. So you can add a new page, you can add somebody else's page if you're gonna market and advertise for them, or you're gonna create a new page for that. With Facebook, you can add a page, right? So obviously, if you already own a page and you come in here and you type in one of your page's URLs, right? So one of your page's URLs might come up in here. So they just type it in and you just click it, and then you just click add page. It's that simple. And that's how you add a page, a Facebook page. Otherwise, when you come in here, you can click request access to a Facebook page. You can type in anything related to something that Sean Stafford Fitness, Amber Day, whatever. So if you know a person's Facebook page, then you type that in. You just click this, click what roles you want, right? If you want insight, how the page content ads performs, the ads access, the content, the community activity. If you're advertising on the page, I'm gonna just select them all and then hit request access. Once you hit request access, they will then go into their business manager account or business.facebook.com and go down into requests, and they'll approve your request. Next, you can create your own page. So you have to select if it's a local business or place, company, organization or institution, brand or product, artist, brand or public figure, entertainment, cause and community. Once you select that, so I'm gonna just hit brand product. I can put the page name here, Awesome Products right? And then I'm going to choose the category. Is it a brand? Is it a board game? Baby goods, clothing, games and toys, kitchen, so forth. So you select the best one in here. And then you're just going to click create page. Obviously, once you create a page, you should go into that page, and I'll show you how to create a page and, you know, develop that page for maximum benefit in another video. But you create that page, just click create, and now that page is now associated with that business manager account. Setting up an ad account. There's multiple options. You can add an ad account of your own. You can add someone else's ad account. You can create a new ad account. So if you already have an ad account, you can add your own ad account. You just click add ad account, and then you enter your own ad account ID. If you already have one, you enter it in this information here. And then obviously if you have someone else's ad account you'd like to add, you request access. You get what is called their ad ID. So if they're looking at their ad account, you can see their ad ID and you can request access to that. Or you should just create a new ad account. So you enter your information here in the ad account name. You can select the time zone. You can select the currency from based off of where you live. And then at that point, you just click the next button. Once you've done all those things, then you've created your own ad account. Obviously, once you've selected the create ad account and you select next on it, it's gonna say if this ad account will be used for your business or other clients or businesses. So you just select that box, hit create, and then that ad account is all set up. It's really that simple. Next step, when your ad account is set up, you want to select the name of the person that's managing it and then how much access they have. If it's admin access, if you just want them to view the performance, manage the campaigns, or so forth, or additional things. Once that's selected, then you can actually see it in your ad manager in that specific account that is managing it. And then it's going to give you a well done message, and then it's all set up as long as you continue to follow those Facebook's advertising policies. The ad account will work just like it's supposed to. Okay, once your ad accounts are set up, you can now add people, and I'm going to walk you through more processes as well as I'm in my actual ad account here. So if you come in here and add people, you're on the people icon, just click add. So you can enter their email address in here. You can select if you want employee access, admin access, to give them full control over accounts and settings and so forth. You can add even additional options if you want a financial analyst, a financial editor, a developer, and so forth, and you just click select. I find a lot of times, unless your email is associated with Facebook, then they might not get an email access to be able to do this. You can add it other ways, add people by just giving them access to the Facebook pages that you want them to manage, and then the ad account ID, either request access that way. So when you add people, that's the quick way to do it. You can also add partners. So if you want to add partners, you just click give a partner access to your assets and ask for their partner ID. So if you want to give them their partner ID access, you go into the business info and you can see your ID, as well as it's also up in the URL. I'm not going to share mine with you because I don't want to access all your stuff. Or you can ask the partner to share their access as well, and you can just follow the steps here and get started with that and adding all that information with a partner access in this. So, and you can create system users. A lot of times you're not going to use this unless you're in a agency and you need to give people more access to be able to access the accounts. So that's where you start with people. Next, so you have your ad account set up, you have your pages set up, you want to start running ads. So first we're going to go into the payment options. I want you to add a payment. So just click add payment in here. And you can just enter your credit card number, your name, information, security, and so forth. And you can hit cancel there. You can also do this when you first start going into, let's say I want to start running ads. So if I come up in here and go to Ads Manager, and let's say my credit card's not set up. If I start setting up an ad and then going to publish, and I hit review and publish on that ad campaign, if the credit card's not set up, then it's going to request access or immediately request to enter in a credit card number. No different than you did in the billing profile section. So again, it's saying, hey, we're not going to run your ad until you give us your credit card information. So that's just finalizing setting up that ad account. So you add that information in here. And that's how you can get started with your ad account. And that's how to do your business manager and set up your business manager. So hopefully that was really helpful. Make sure you follow all the steps to get your business manager set up. I will show you future videos on how to run ads, how to set up catalogs, and more things with Facebook as well as other platforms that you can advertise on. Hopefully this was helpful and useful for you to set up your business manager, and hopefully you understand why it's so important when you're starting to advertise to set up business manager right off the bat and get it set up correctly so you can do things like I said, catalogs and your pixels, and run ads more effectively using that business manager account. All right, thank you. If you have any questions, please in the comments below, tell me if this was helpful. Give me a like. I appreciate that. It's always great for the YouTube algorithm and all that lovely stuff. But anyway, thank you and have a great day.